Hi, welcome to Numerix Video Blog. I'm your host, Jim Jockel. Looking at the Brexit fallout, as we're only a week later, a couple challenges continue to rise in the market. Joining me today for a discussion is Udi Sella, Vice President of Business Development for EMEA. Welcome, Udi. How are you, sir?
Thank you. Good morning to you, Jim.
So I want to talk about cross gamma, especially as it relates to CVA, a big challenge that's been kind of widely discussed in the inner circles of the banking industry and starting to get a little bit into the mainstream. So Udi, why don't you give us a quick primer on what's going on as it relates to CVA and the issues with the creation of Brexit and cross gamma?
So when we look at CVA and the family of XVA, the different valuation adjustments. Well, when banks need to set aside capital to hedge against counterparty defaults, there are a few factors that play in. The two most prominent are the CDS spreads and then the volatility. Now, we often talk about wrong side risk, but in fact, what we just found now with the Brexit was that there was a double whammy for banks trying to hedge those valuation adjustment exposures. And what happened was is obviously the Brexit is an event that happens in, I don't know, every 10 or even more years, maybe every 20 years. And since the markets these days are so correlated, the moves were very violent and across the board. So specifically, obviously, volatility shot up, almost doubled, if you like. And at the same time, the CDS spreads opened. So basically, the cost of insuring risk increased. And since these are correlated, it meant very large, significant CVA adjustments for the banks. And in some European banks, we're talking in the order of $25 to $50 million just in one day. Now, since we're looking here at cross gammas, the hedging is almost impossible because we're looking at cross correlation. And this is basically it. This is really what happened.
So, but Udi, arguably, this is a political event. This isn't a systematic shock to the financial system, as we've seen in 2008 or other areas. There is liquidity in the marketplace. One could presume that across the banking sector, the CDS spreads outside of perhaps specific UK banks just were reacting systemically across the marketplace. How is that going to play out longer term, where a political event starts to really play out as an event or shock to the financial system?
Yeah, so there's a few things to say here. So indeed, liquidity was there. We didn't hear of market, stop unfunctioning. But the bid-ask spreads in swaps, and specifically CDSs, opened by a factor of 7. So basically getting in and out was much more difficult. The friction in positions, obviously the cost of trading and hedging increased significantly. So that's the first thing I wanted to mention. The second thing is that the central banks seem to have been ready for that and prepared and actually provided an allotted liquidity into the market, which helped significantly the market function. We haven't heard of any event of, systems timing out because of fraud. The only thing that fell was the ASUS website for purchasing in sterling. So that's fine. I mean, the markets can deal with that. And in the long term, I think this would imply more out-of-the-money hedging, exactly to hedge those systemic risks. And we mentioned, elections in the UK. There's a lot of uncertainty there. There is uncertainty when when and will the UK invoke the famous Article 50. We don't know if there is negotiation behind the scenes to keep the UK within the European Union. Let's say what would happen if the UK eventually doesn't leave European Union. Will that create a shock? Most likely, yes. And then, of course, we have the U.S. elections in November, right? So which also can generate a huge move in the market. So I think we are to see increased volatility levels at least almost through the end of this year.
Well, Udi, you neglected to mention one final shock, which was the defeat of England by Iceland. Critically important.
I'm in London. I can see the faces.
So, Udi, I want to thank you so much for your perspective. And, of course, we want to talk to you as this continues to play out over the volatile summer months as well, and then rolling into what's going to be a tumultuous fall with all the elections. And, of course, we always want to talk about the topics you want to talk about. So please follow us on LinkedIn or on Twitter at NX Analytics. Udi, thank you so much for your time and your insight.